Hi everybody, name's Matt, social media manager here at Volusion, and welcome to 2 Minute Tuesdays, where you give you 2 minutes of e-commerce advice to bolster your online success. Now the first step to any healthy SEO or pay-per-click campaign for that matter is to conduct solid keyword research. But if you don't want to hire a professional, it's going to take a lot of work. So with that in mind, I've got 5 things that you should do to help you perform keyword research without going insane. Now first, you'll just want to start with a simple brainstorm. So for example, let's say I have an online store that's called Matt's Organic Hot Sauce. I just sit down with a pen and paper or an Excel spreadsheet and create a list of all of the potential keywords that people might search for to come to your store. Now once you've exhausted your own mind, feel free to bring in friends, family, acquaintances, just to get a new perspective. Now secondly, I recommend that you are inspired heavily by your competitors by taking a look and seeing what keywords they're using. To do so, all you have to do is visit their website, right-click or click View in your browser, select Page Source, then go to the metadata, and then in the description tag, you can see a list of keywords that they're using, and you can use that to your own advantage. Now, third on our list, I highly recommend using a keyword suggestion tool. Google AdWords has a great one, and there are lots of other ones out there too if you just do a search for this tool. And really, you just put in various keywords and it will suggest several others. Now, what's also cool is it'll tell you how many searches come in each month and how competitive those keywords are. So, really a great way to get an overall perspective of how your keywords are looking. Now, fourthly, once you have your keywords all listed out, you want to separate and organize them into nice little piles. So, for example, you can take a look at your branded versus category keywords. Branded, in my case, would be brand name related, so Matt's Organic Hot Sauce, whereas category keywords would be more general, like hot sauce, pecan sauce, organic hot sauce, etc. Now, you can also take a look at your large scale versus your long tail keywords. Large scale, again, more general, shorter in length. Long tail, on the other hand, a lot longer and more specific. The idea here is once you separate them out, you can then plan your approach to how you'll implement your campaigns. And last but definitely not least, once you have all your keywords together, you want to prioritize your plan of attack. So, do you want to focus on creating content for your long tail keywords first, or do you need to go back and create content that really focuses on more of your branded keywords? Once you have all of these things organized, it's really helpful for you to go through and time out your approach so you have the best SEO gains in the fastest amount of time. Hopefully this list of tips will keep your keyword research on track and get your SEO efforts up in no time whatsoever. If you have any questions, just leave a comment in the box below. Get right back to you. From me to you, happy selling.